Christians often enter forums and seek out videos discussing atheists, or even science, and begin preaching. Many atheists just begin to mock and ridicule them, and rightfully so. So why do they continue to do this? Stop and consider for a moment that not all Christians do. The ones more likely to do this are often the same ones who use their scripture to mask some hatred. This hatred justification is the key to why they are preaching so much, and why they preach specifically to atheists. There are a few different reasons for this. The first and most common is that they know they are wrong, but want to believe so much that they need everyone to agree with their belief, thus bolstering their weak, blind faith. The reason this is the most common is due to the fact that the human brain does not like blind faith. Not to be confused, of course, with validated faith. A mental disorder similar to blind faith is phobia. An irrational fear of something that is not inherently dangerous is a lot like an irrational belief in something that is not inherently believable. The desire to believe is strong and more real than the blind faith, and it can drive people to extremes in order to justify that belief. This is why they often resort to insults or somehow dehumanizing the atheists with expressions of anger when challenged. Another type, and one that is very sad, is the by proxy conversion. This one is sad because it goes beyond just wanting to believe. It's wanting to convert themselves. They know their religious beliefs they claim are completely illogical and contrived, yet they cannot face this fact. However, they have to hold on to these beliefs to justify their own desires and lives. So why do they preach to everyone else? Because they aren't. They are preaching it to themselves and hoping to convert themselves. They preach to the atheists, rarely resorting to outright insults, but instead use common phrases like bless you or I'll pray for you, as they see themselves as the atheist. The by proxy preachers are trying to convince themselves that their beliefs are correct by proxy. So they engage the atheist, often ignoring all facts and logic that demonstrate the falseness of their beliefs, while continuing to assert repetitively that they just know their beliefs are true. In short, they are the atheist they are trying to convert. The problem is, by proxy conversions do not help to convince them. Even if every single atheist they spoke to converted to their way of thinking, they would still not be satisfied. When no atheist is around, the entire conversation is about nothing but reinforcing their beliefs. These sad believers, or non-believers technically, are really lying to themselves so much they believe that lie. To spot these ones, just look for the typical claim that anything which makes their doctrine look bad is being taken out of context. By proxy preachers are also much like conspiracy theorists. Alien abductions, Bigfoot, New World Order type beliefs are much the same. They want so much to belong to something that knows more, but since they cannot rationalize these, they have to continually convert themselves by preaching it to anyone who doubts them. I often make the assertion that hatred should not be shamed, and that people should be allowed to admit when they hate something. I have a very logical reason for this. The by proxy preacher is one of those reasons. The third and worst of the online preachers are my primary reason. Similar to the by proxy preacher, the third type is using the beliefs to justify their hatred and fear. But they know it. These are the easiest ones to spot. They will repeat the messages of the doctrine that justify their hatred and fear, but completely ignore all other portions of the doctrine, even the good parts that should be followed. These are the types that are likely to be associated with the racist groups or other various hate groups that remain relatively hidden in the physical world. Online, they can preach their hate in the open because of the illusion of anonymity. Society has pushed them into the closet to try to make things safer for everyone, but at a high cost. They have not lost their hatred, and they spread the messages of hate in secret now instead of in the open. This has created a ticking time bomb that we can't see, at least until now. In my last video, I spoke more on the benefits of free speech online. But really, we should encourage these hate mongers to come out into the open, into the physical world as well. Like the Westboro Baptist Church, when we know they're there, and when they're open about their hatred, they're much easier to avoid, protect everyone else from, and to let everyone know these people are not good role models.